For 10 years, Melburnians have lined up patiently for a taste of Kate Reid's croissants, once judged the best in the world.
So good.
Wow, that's amazing.
It's 11 o'clock on a weekday. Does this blow your mind? People are queuing up out the door.
Every day. Blows my mind. It's very humbling.
Kate's drive for perfection didn't start with croissants. It started here.
Midfielder fights, fights, fights and retakes the lead.
Melbourne's first Grand Prix.
Absolutely incredible.
You could hear the squeal of the V10 engine and I was like, oh my God, what is that? And suddenly this thing that I couldn't even lock eyes on flashed past me. I'm like, that was it. I had to be a part of that world.
After studying aerospace engineering, she was off to London as an aerodynamicist for Williams Racing.
I could reach out and touch the F1 car, so that was a real pinch myself moment.
But she soon discovered working in F1 wasn't what she'd hoped for.
I was the only female that worked in the aero building. That was 120 staff, and I was the only female that had a technical role at Williams at the time.
Instead of collaborating with her colleagues, she found herself sitting in front of a computer for 16 to 18 hours a day alone.
That was maybe the start of the slippery slope of discovering that this thing I'd worked so hard to get to wasn't quite what I imagined.
How was your mental health at that point?
Deteriorating rapidly, but at some point the depression turned into an eating disorder. It was, I guess, my way to control areas of my life where I felt like other areas, like my career, were out of control.
As Kate's anorexia took its toll, her father flew to the UK to bring her home to Melbourne, where she applied for a job at a bakery.
And it was just working on the counter, and it was in equal parts wonderful and torture, because you're surrounded by the thing that you won't let yourself have. So it's like a battle of willpower. But going through that process and that illness had that beautiful silver lining of allowing me to find baking.
As she slowly recovered, Kate found new inspiration in a book on French patisseries. Before she knew it, she was an apprentice in one of the best bakeries in Paris.
A plus, merci.
I've never felt more stimulated in a job. My French was getting better and I was exhausted at the end of the day, but learning these incredible French techniques.
But after a month, she decided to return to Australia.
So when you left France, did you know how to make a croissant?
Yeah, no, safe to say I had maybe 10% of the knowledge and I was pretty ignorant when I came back.
Kate would not be deterred.
I spent all of my days off travelling around Melbourne in the hope that I would find that croissant that would take me back to that Parisian experience, and it just didn't exist at the time. And I guess one day I had a little light bulb moment where I thought, well, I know everything that there is to know about croissants. Huh. Maybe I could start a small business.
And she did. Here, at this hole in the wall in Elwood, working alongside her brother Cam, Lune came to life.
We were doing 80, 90-hour weeks in this tiny little kitchen that were only open to the public maybe 4.5 hours a week.
Looking back, Kate credits Cam with helping her on the road to recovery.
It's honestly the only reason that Lune was able to grow. He was so beautiful. He metaphorically held my hand through the whole thing and was like, Katie, that thing that you're doing, someone else can do that so you can focus on this.
So she focused on creating the perfect croissant.
I just obsessively recipe tested, and every day I would change one variable. And finally, after about 3 or so months, I landed on this product that I felt was good enough to maybe take out to the market.
In no time, Lune launched to cult status and Kate's croissants were getting international recognition.
Yotam Ottolenghi says that your croissants are the blueprint for what all croissants should be.
Yeah, way to make me get emotional.
Wow.
I mean, even hearing a statement like that still makes me feel an out-of-body experience and humbled, and maybe I'm hopefully onto something.
In 2016, New York Times made a big call. Kate's croissants were the best in the world.
Oliver Strand came down to the store in Elwood and sat next to me with a friend while I baked, and I had no idea who he was. And when him and the friend asked if they could have one, I said, you can pick one because we've got a long line of people and I can't give you any more than that. So his review was based on half a plain croissant sitting on the steps next to me in Elwood.
She's still the pastry perfectionist, out and about with her sidekick Lily, making sure the quality of her croissants never slips.
It's not as easy as it looks, is it?
No, it actually isn't.
Kate Kate's written her own cookbook and, like her croissant, her empire has risen and expanded. Three stores in Melbourne, two in Brisbane and two more planned for Sydney.
So what is next for you?
Well, I think Lune's in a very exciting position at the moment where we could go in a number of different directions, and world domination is obviously one of them.
And don't ever doubt the curative powers of croissant.
I guess in the end, finding the baking was the thing that healed me. There just wasn't any room for the eating disorder anymore. So Lune was a big part in helping me move on.
Honestly, as a Sydney cider, Lune is probably your best export.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh, it brings words. Me back. It's not the project. Yeah. It is a Lune croissant.
I'm not sure it's an export because you can't have it.
Yeah,
okay,
exactly.
All right, you know what? It sounded good.
Actually, there are stores coming to Sydney, can I just say?
There you
yeah,
go.
Yeah.
So,
and grab Kate's cookbook as well. She is such a dynamo, incredible woman.
How many croissants or croissants did you eat?
She doesn't mind. She doesn't mind if you say croissant.
Okay. No, sometimes. How many did you eat? That's the question.